Welcome, everyone. Thank you so much for coming. Wow, God is good. Today we are going to have a lot of prayer. Today, in fact, is a deliverance night. Things, it's not going to be the same again. No. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I need more hearts. I need you to do your best. Today we are going to reach 2 million. I look young. Yes, my son. This is your mother. Yes, God is good. Good. Yeah, I have to press myself and say, yay, God is good. We love God because He is good. I have refused to be sad, and I've refused to follow anything that wants to stress me. A lady called me from London, from England, UK. She was crying. She said she's so sad. She doesn't have friends. She's not happy. She was talking to me so much. I told her, you choose like that. I've refused. Nothing will make me too sad. Even if they will come, I'll refuse. I'll say, no. Go away where you came from. So, and the joy of the Lord is my strength. Yes, I know sometimes it's a difficult time, but you have to refuse and say, no. You have to go back where you came from. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. Hallelujah. God is good. Yeah. Thank you for coming. We are going to start soon because I have so much prayers that I want to pray. We are going to attack every type of works of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. Wow. Yes. Yes, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you, before your throne, before your presence tonight, God, to honor you, to thank you, and to give you all the glory. My Father and my God, I bleed the blood of Jesus. I breathe the blood of Jesus. I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. I cover this periscope with the blood of Jesus. I bleed the blood of Jesus. My Father and my God, I draw a wall of fire around me. I draw a wall of fire around me in the mighty name of Jesus. Any evil arrows fired to me, I command them to go back to the sender. Every evil monitoring me, every spells and chants, all wicked personality chanting against me, speaking against me, speaking against the prayers, chanting and saying evil and against the prayers, programming serpent and scorpion, let them burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Let them be destroyed. I know the Holy Spirit was revealed to me how people sitting down, chanting me, pointing me at with their wicked horn, witchcraft are bad. They are pointing me and chanting and speaking evil against me. Let the fire of God consume them. Today is the night that we are going to condemn every witchcraft, every powers of the witchcraft, and all their sources is going to catch fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father, I pray and I thank you that God, you are able. You are able, God. Everyone who is sitting to monitor me, to point evil horn to me, chants and spells on me, I destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I know that there is wicked people personality that is they are chanting and speaking evil against this prayer against me. Let their evil ways, what they are saying, let it turn to their own heart and destroy them in Jesus' name. I pray that God Almighty will protect me and the family and overcome as deliverance and healing ministry family. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, I bless your name. I give you all the glory, Jesus. You are wonderful. You are what God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Amen. I'm going to talk to you the subject called the power of possibilities and deliverance. 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 And I'm going to read from the book of Exodus 6, chapter 6, verse 6. The Bible says, therefore, say unto the children of Israel, I am the Lord, and I will bring you out from under the burdens of the Egyptians, and I will deliver you out of their bondage, and I will redeem you with an outstretched arm and with great judgments. So the Lord told Moses to go and tell the children of Israel that the Lord is going to deliver them from the bondage, from the hands of Pharaoh. Tell your enemy. Tell your enemy. Enemy that is in you. Whether it's anger, whether it's sickness, whether it's poverty, whether it's barrenness, any enemy in you, tell that enemy. Tell them that the Lord has said is coming to deliver me tonight. Talk to that enemy that is in you. Every enemy that is working against you, talk to them. You know the enemy that is in you. You know the problem that you are facing. That is the enemy. If it is your marriage, wherever, anything that is in you, that is your enemy. So tell that enemy, that is bondage. Anything you are facing tonight, you have been facing, that is bondage. That attack you have been attacking, being attacked all the time, that is a bondage. Talk to them. Talk to anything that is working against you. Anything that is facing you. If you are looking for a job that is jobless, talk to that jobless. Tell the jobless, you job, hear the word of God. The Lord is going to deliver me tonight. That is the book of Exodus. God told Moses, tell the children of Israel, I am going to deliver them with the great judgment. Judgment is going to fall upon your enemies. Judgment is going to fall upon witchcraft. Every witchcraft practicing under the water, the judgment of God is going to follow them in the mighty name of Jesus. This is a very powerful scripture that you may tell your enemies. If you are troubling with problems and issues, tell that enemies, therefore says unto the children of Israel, I am the Lord, I will bring you out from under the burden of Egyptians, and I will deliver you out of their bondage. You are going to be delivered from every burden of Egyptians. Egyptians is a burden that does not want you to go, to make you suffer and being treated, being a slave. That is Egyptians. The Lord is going to deliver you tonight, whether the devil like it or not. Today is your big deliverance in the mighty name of Jesus. Impossibility, the God of impossibility is going to visit you. Look at another scripture from the book of Genesis 18, verse 14. The book of Genesis 18, verse 14. The Bible says, is anything too difficult for the Lord? At the appointed time, I will return to you. At this time, next year, and Sarah will have a son. God is asking, is there anything difficult? Is there anything too difficult for the Lord? The angel was asking, do you know that there is nothing difficult to God to do? God is God, is power. If we can divide the Red Sea and the children of Israel pass through, if God changed water to become blood, if God opened the ground and the human being swallowed the ground open and they were swallowed there, Is there anything too difficult that God cannot do? Is anything too difficult for God that he cannot do? Every situation you are facing, God is able to do it. God is able to deliver you and take it away. I have seen crippled people being healed. I have seen so many testimony upon testimony. I've seen a man who was suffocated. He was not eating for 3 months. 3 weeks straight away, not even swallowing slavery. 3 weeks straight away, not swallowing. And he was tried. His throat was tried. The doctor tried. They didn't know. The man was panicking because he feared that he's going to die. And God delivered that man straight away when he came to our prayer. Here in our prayer in a deliverance meeting, here in Brandon, where we are, the man has a testimony there. There is nothing difficult that God cannot do. God is able. God is able. Your situation is nothing. Yes. If God can turn the water to become blood, if God can turn the water to become wine, if God can make the Red Sea to melt, divided, and the people were walking on the middle of the water, on the side, God is able to deliver you every situation you are facing tonight. Any power that is saying that God is not able is a lie. Let's look another scripture. The Bible says from the book of Jeremiah 32 verse 17. The Bible says, Lord God, behold, you have made heavens and the earth by your great power and by your outstretched arm. Nothing is too difficult for you. God is the one who made heaven and earth. God is the one who created everything you see, anything breathing, insect, anything you see is the one who created. So there is nothing difficult to God. Thank you, Jesus. He is able. God is able. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. What are you facing? What are you facing today? What situation are you facing that God cannot do? Remind him that he is able to do everything that you are looking for. There is nothing that God cannot do. God is able. If God can make Sarah a menopause past a woman who had given hope, who has lost hope, and 100 men to give birth, is that the God that you can joke with? When Sarah heard that he's going to have a child, Sarah laughed. They said, God, you are joking. Then the angel asked God, what did you say? God asked, what did you say, Sarah? Sarah said, no, I didn't say anything. Who did your Bible? Sarah said, no, I didn't say anything. Then he asked, why are you laughing? You think I'm joking? I don't joke. I am God. I am God. As he said that I am the Lord. Look at that the Exodus. He said, I am the Lord. I am the Lord. My name is the Lord God. Yahweh, King of kings and Lord of lords. There's nothing difficult for God to do. When God went to Egypt, he delivered the children from Egypt. He would deliver you. He would deliver your situation. He would deliver your problem. Whether the witchcraft like it or not, God is going to deliver you. Jesus said something here. The book of Matthew 19, verse 26. Jesus also said something. This is the New Testament. Jesus said, and looking at them, Jesus said to them, with the people, this is impossible. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. You see, Jesus, and looking at them, Jesus said to them, with people, this is impossible, but with God, all things are possible. To people, to human beings, it looks impossible, but with God, it is possible. There is nothing difficult that God cannot do. In the mighty name of Jesus, you remember what God says. God is able. God is able. God is able. Hallelujah. I am going to pray for you because I know I have so much prayers that I pray. We are going to deal with the scripture which says Exodus 6 and 6, chapter 6, verse 6. That you tell the enemy. Tell the enemy that is affecting you. Tell that enemy that the Lord has said he is going to deliver me. Any witchcraft practicing under the water, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I destroy them. Any witchcraft practicing under any water against your life, I command them to receive judgment of God with the fire immediately in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever there are some people, they are being affected by water spirit. They are affected by the spirit of malign. They are affected from powers of witchcraft. They are affected from powers of witchcraft. Yes. Yes. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that any child of the devil that has been sent by the devil to bring destruction be scattered and be scattered in the name of Jesus. We don't need any destruction in Periscope. If you are not members of Overcomers or you are not invited, get away from Periscope. Don't bring destruction. I pray that let the judgment of God fall upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. We don't come here to fight. We have come to pray. People have difficult. People have problems. So if you come with your games, get out from Periscope in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. Jesus, we give you the glory. My God, let every evil altar under water upon which certain evil are done against you be roasted in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty, I am attacking the water spirit. I'm attacking the world of water. That's where many people the witchcraft have been tying them. They are doing the witchcraft from the water. I have seen that water spirit is now affecting so many people. That's why I'm attacking them. God is going to deliver you from the spirit of water, from witchcraft water, that witchcraft that is practicing witchcraft against you, practice in under the water. I am praying that let that water be dried up in the name of Jesus. I pray that every minister, every satanic minister, every evil priest ministering at an evil altar against you inside any water, I command them to fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Any power under liver or sea, remote controlling your life, I command them to be destroyed by fire and shake yourself loose from your hold in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I am praying that God Almighty will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I want to thank you, Father. I destroy every power monitoring you. Today, God is going to deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. Powers of darkness monitoring you. Every satanic mirror monitoring you. I command them to crash land and die in the name of Jesus. When they come to visit you, let them meet the lock of ages and crush them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, we thank you, Father. Lord, we praise your name. I bless your name, God. I give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that every agent of marine witchcraft physically attached to your marriage to frustrate it, fall down and perish in the name of Jesus. Those people, their marriage has been attacked. Your marriage has been attacked. People who are not been married. People are married and their marriage has been attacked. They are not happy with their marriage. I am praying for you. Single mother, single people. All these people who are not married, this is your prayer. Today, God is going to deliver you. You are going to get your partner who loves you, who takes care of you. All those wicked ones who threaten you, so evil, so wicked, they will get away in the name of Jesus. No matter if you are, even if you are 70 years, God will get your partner and you will be happy in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that every agent of marine witchcraft physically attached to your marriage to frustrate it, fall down and perish in the name of Jesus. I am attacking this marine spirit that is attacking your finances, attacking your marriage. People are married, they are attacking them so much. People are not married, they are marrying them in the spiritual world. That's why they can't get married. They want themselves. So I pray that today the bondage of Egypt is going to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. There is nothing too difficult that God cannot do. There is nothing too difficult. Jesus said, to man it's impossible, but God it's possible. Therefore, any prosperity of God, God is able. There is power of prosperity that is going to deliver you. Don't look at your age. God is able. God Almighty, God is able to turn things around you and favor you in the name of Jesus. If God can give Sarah at her age a child, what about you? You are not the age of Sarah. You are not the age of Abraham. Even if you are the age of Abraham, chances is there that God is going to visit you in the mighty name of Jesus. God is going to make you millionaire in a short time. Some of you are going to have money you have never seen. God is going to revive your business. You will get a job. God is going to get a job and you will get a big job, a big position even you didn't go to school. I pray that God, in the name of Jesus, will open a big door for you in the name of Jesus. Poverty will get out of your life. You will never see that poverty again in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Every agent of marine witchcraft assigned to attack your finances through dreams, I command them to fall down and perish in the name of Jesus. Every marine witchcraft attacking your finances, some people that are affected, their finances, they don't have money. Their finances is so attacked. That's why I'm going to pray today. The Lord is going to deliver you. The Lord is going to deliver your finances. If you are the person who have been struggling with your finances is going to be delivered in Jesus' name. I am attacking them from the marine agents that is attacking your finances. I am commanding them to fall down and be destroyed in Jesus' name. When you are dreaming, in your dreams they attack you. You are losing your purse. You are losing your bag. They are giving you money, coin. That's not nice. When they give you money, they give you satanic money, witchcraft money. Then you are happy to receive it. And when you receive it, they take away everything you have. So I destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. I pull down every stronghold of bewitchment, enchantment, chants, divination, fashioned against you by marine witches in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, let the thunder and the fire of God rocket the storehouse and the strong rooms of household witchcraft, hovering your blessings, and I pull them down in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I am praying to you tonight that let any witchcraft curses working against you be revoked by the blood of Jesus. You know, they are there to put the curses, they are there to see that you will never be happy. The Bible says that tell them that God is God who is going to deliver them with great judgment. Anybody that is attacking you tonight will call his parable. Therefore, I'm praying that God will deliver you tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Any witch, if you feel that you are being witched, some witchcraft are attacking you all the time. Today is the end of their life. If they will try to come to you, you will hear what is going to happen to you. Because the only sentences God himself has done to witchcraft is put them to death. He said, let them die, let them be destroyed. That's why we say die. So their powers will die. If their powers will die, they wouldn't have anything to come and witch you. God has put them sentences. He says, suffer not a witch to live. That's why we attack the powers. We are attacking their powers to die. We are not attacking the human being. The powers they are using is the one we are attacking them to die. I pray that's why we pray that cancer, that sickness to die. If the sickness die, then it could not survive. That's how we use a lot of die. we know the spirit does not die, but the power behind that spirit, if that power dies, then you will be free. You understand? I pray that God would destroy every power behind you to be destroyed completely and die. Destroy means vanish. Die. That is what we know. Jesus Christ came to destroy the works of the devil. That's what I repeat to say every day. I destroy with the fire of God every weapon of witchcraft used to affect you in the mighty name of Jesus. This weapon of witchcraft affecting you, I am commanding them to be destroyed by fire. That weapon of witchcraft, the weapon of witchcraft, I am attacking them because most people that are being witched, you know, we have Pentecostal witchcraft in the churches. We have pastors and priests and false prophets. They are full of witchcraft. They do things with witchcraft. They don't do things with God. They are double. They are on the side of God and the side of the devil. So therefore, they do that, and that's why I'm praying that God will destroy them in Jesus' name. Any materials taken from you, from your body, pressed on any witchcraft altar, I command them to be roasted by fire of God in Jesus' name. I reverse every witchcraft barrier fashioned against you. They will not fashion. No weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. Any weapon that is fashioned against you, they shall scatter. They shall be condemned in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I am praying that the Lord Almighty will deliver you from the hands of any witchcraft practicing under the water, fashioned any evil against you shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. They put a trap on you so that you can enter in. Let those drop the boot, let them catch the honor in Jesus' name. I am going to pray for witchcraft bad rock, because some people are rocked. The witchcraft have rocked them and put the rock on their pocket. There was a story the Father and the Lord was sharing with us. He was saying that there was a young girl of like less than 8 years. This girl, she went with a friend, and they initiated her to witchcraft. So the child was a witch at the age of 8 years. She was a witch. And now, as she was practicing, she was told to donate his brother. Her brother. He went and he donated, because he didn't understand this. He gave it his brother. Then his brother, he was a lawyer, he died. Then again, after the funeral finished, and he was asked, and she was told to bring another one. Then she also wrote another one. That one also was an engineer or a teacher. That one also died. Now this girl's dearest, she's going to remain alone by herself. So she went and told the pastor, "Pastor, please pray for me. Something is not right. Pray for me." Then the pastor asked her, "What do you want me to pray for you?" She said that, "I went to my friend and they told me this. Now, see, when anytime they ask me to give my brother or a person from my family, that person dies. So I feel like they have given me witchcraft. I'm a witch." So this child is a child of 8 years. She has killed his two brothers. Two brothers. They are dying. They have killed them. So that's why you need to make sure that you know to pray this witchcraft bad rock. Now the pastor was asking her, "Where do you keep that power?" She said that, "I lock them. I lock them and I swallow the rocks on my, it is in my heart. It's in my belly. So that's why that's where I keep the power." Then this pastor says, "Can you remove that bad rock from your belly?" She said yes. And then she vomited. That thing came out. And the girl was free from that spirit of witchcraft. So they can badlock you and swallow it in their belly. That's satanic. Satanic, the way they operate, you can't even understand. You can't know. These computers, They understood the computers than anybody. They are satanic. The way they do the things, you can't even know. You cannot understand. But the truth of the matter, it is there. It is bad luck is there. You know the keys that we have been given. Jesus said, "I have been given you the key to open." Peter, I've given you the key of heaven. So now the devil, when he had the key of heaven, he went and make his own bad rock to rock people through witchcraft. So this is there. It is working to people. Therefore, I pray that every witchcraft bad luck fashioned against any area of your life, I command them to be roasted by fire. Any child that has been initiated to witchcraft, either if it is your child, may God deliver this child not to kill anybody in the mighty name of Jesus. Any human being that initiating these young people, they are very innocent. May God, may the judgment of God fall upon them and destroy them in Jesus' name. I pray that God would deliver them from the hands of the witches and wizards in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That's why you need prayer. When these witches has initiated your children and you are not aware, and the children, if they don't go to the church so that they can pray for, they can be easily initiated. I know even some kids in our ministry, they were nearly be initiated to be witchcraft, but we thank God we rescued them before they enter into it. Right now, by this time, they could have been a witch, and the parents, they would not be able to identify. They would only notice things are changing. Therefore, I pray, let wisdom of your household enemies overturn them and be thrown in Jesus' name. Every household, wisdom of your household enemies, let us overturn them in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that God will deliver you in Jesus' name. Let the wicked of the household enemies overturn them in Jesus' name. Oh yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus. My God, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I want to thank God. I want to thank God for you in Jesus' name. I am praying, let all satanic forces contributing to kill your marriage be barrised in the name of Jesus. I pray for those people who are suffering, who their marriage has been attacked very hard. I am praying for you that any satanic forces contributing to kill your marriage, let them be barrised in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. My Father, let marriage killers be barrised in the name of Jesus. I pray, let marriage killers be barrised in the name of Jesus. Let every activity of household enemies of your marriage be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, I pray because I know some people that are going through difficult their marriage. That enemy want to kill your marriage. Let that enemy be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I pray restoration of your marriage in the mighty name of Jesus. Sickness, the enemy that is attacking you with the sickness, hear the word of God. Talk to that sickness. Tell that sickness today the Lord is delivering you with the great judgment in the mighty name of Jesus. That sickness that does not want to leave you, by the power and the blood of Jesus, let it be roasted. Let that sickness be roasted in the mighty name of Jesus. The pain that you have been going through, that pain in your back, that pain in your nails, that pain in your shoulder that does not want to go, I set that pain fire, and they must get out by fire, by thunder, in the mighty name of Jesus. Witchcraft pain programmed by Satan in your body, I command them to catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my God, I pray that God would deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. God, my God, I call upon you. I call upon your presence. I call upon you now by the power and the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, you are a great God, my Father. Let all the enemies scatter. Let all the enemies scatter from your house. Scatter from your place of work. Let your enemies scatter from anywhere where you are going. Wherever they see you, where you are stepped, they will scatter and give you the way in the mighty name of Jesus. You are a child of God. You are calling fire of God in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever you walk, let your enemies flee. And according to the word of God, the Bible says they run away and no one is chasing them because of the presence you have. The presence you are carrying in the mighty name of Jesus. You have given, God has given you dominion and authority that you will stop, you will stumble on serpents and scorpions. Nothing by all means hurt you. Now you let things to hurt you. You let things to upset you. You let things to rule you. Refuse in the name of Jesus. That's why yesterday I put that video. The video is on now. Manipulation and controlling spirit. You refuse completely to be controlled by the demons, by evil people. You have to refuse that the serpent and scorpion cannot stop on you. You are the one to stomp on serpent and scorpion. You don't need them to work on you. They are demons. Scorpions are demons. Serpents are snakes. So snakes is a form of Satan. We have been given authority and power over him. That's how you see. Now, if Jesus has said so, which means that you can work on them. Don't let them to work on you. That's why you need to open your eyes and ears to say you have power. Jesus said, even if you have little faith as little as mustard seed, you can still move mountain. Don't think that your faith is so small that you cannot drive out demon. Cast your demons from your body. Cast them. Command them to get out. You have been given authority. If you see the book of Mark 16, verse 15 to 20, you will see how God has given you power. He doesn't give pastors or bishop or prophetess. He has given everyone who believes in the name of Jesus Christ. He said, these things are for those who believe in me. In my name, they shall cast out demons. You will cast demons. You don't have to let the demon to rule you, to torment you. You are being attacked. All the demons are attacking you. Some people, they call me when they are so depressed that the demons are attacking you. Take authority. Take authority after them. Take authority to get out from your life in the name of Jesus. You have been given power and authority in the name of Jesus. You can pray the prayer that will make them to run away and to run away, not to come near you. Yes, I pray that let the anointing to prosper fall upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the anointing of prosper to fall upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that God will bless you and God will open new doors that no one will close it, no one will shut it in the mighty name of Jesus. You will go where they said you cannot go, you will go. If they say that job, you will not get it, you will get it. If you are opening a new business, go ahead and open. Anything you want to do, God has opened for you. Go. God is going to give it to you. No, there is nothing too difficult that God cannot do, no matter what it is. What God cannot do is evil. God cannot do evil if you decide to go and take somebody's husband or somebody's wife. God cannot do that. Because I know wicked people like that. There was a song we used to sing in the church. That church, when we used to be in the church in Africa. This is the brother that the Lord has for me. Now the song was saying, this is the brother the Lord has given me. This is the sister the Lord has made. Now the brothers, they squeeze people's hand. They say, yes, this is the sister the Lord has given me. Now because of that, they go and do fornication. They say, did you hear what the pastor was singing, was telling us to sing? This is the brother the Lord has met. This is the sister God has met. And then they change it and they go and do evil. God cannot be responsible for that. That's flesh. So I pray that you cannot be ruled by the flesh. Go for the spiritual things. I am talking only spiritual things. If you are going to do evil, then you think God will help because you have heard that there is nothing difficult to God. That is a lie. Because some people, they twist the things and say, yes, I know God can do everything, so I can go and break the bank and they will take care of me. Don't do that. Or you say God can, you start selling drugs because you think there is nothing difficult to God. You can do everything you want. God is a holy God. Anything that you are doing must glorify God, not glorifying the devil. If you are going to glorify anything with the devil, then God will not be there. That would be impossible. God is impossibilities his way when he wants to acknowledge his work, his creation, what he does. That one he will deliver you. Like what he promised the children of Israel. I pray that God will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I fire back every arrow of the enemy. Fired at your business. Fired at your work. Fired at your marriage. Fired at your place of work. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, I let the power sucking the peace of your home be rendered important in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power sucking your peace. People, they have no peace at home. They feel like they would stay somewhere. They don't want to go home because there's no peace home. When you reach home, you find your husband is not talking to you. When you reach home, you find even the children, they are against you. There's a lot of confusion in the home. Let that demon that has been assigned to your home to be destroyed and be rendered powerless in Jesus' name. The demon that is fighting your children, the children start fighting each other. Those children, they cannot get you. It is the demon. They cannot give you peace. I pray that let those demons that is sent by the devil in the mighty name of Jesus to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yes, they're sucking the peace. They suck your peace. You need to have peace, but because of this enemy, they suck peace from the home, and you remain, the home is scattered. It's like, it's not like a home. Therefore, I pray that those demons that has been sent to suck the peace of your home, let them catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. You find whole people, they have been living very happy. They never fight, but suddenly something happened. They start fighting. Then you wonder. My pastor is always tell us that there's some story, and it's true because he's a counselor, and the people goes for him for prayer. A man, a pastor of 75 years, he was found with 20 years old girl, fornicating with that 20 years old girl. Now the pastor decided to divorce his wife to marry this 20 years old girl because the woman is old. That is witchcraft. That's demons. You see? Now a pastor decided to say, no, I don't want you now. I'm divorcing you. They have been living together 75 years. And the man, a pastor, just went and found, because he's a pastor, and found a 20 years old. And this girl wants to be married by this man, and they have agreed to divorce the mother, the whole, the grandmother now, the wife, who is a grandmother. That child, the girl of 20, is a grandmother of that wife that is going to chase away. So our pastor was telling us. And then I said, wow, the devil is a liar. And this is what they do. If you cannot pray very well, they will come and scatter your home. I pray that God, it will not happen to you. Let it happen to the devil himself and his agents in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Jesus, I thank you, Lord. Let the blood of Jesus raise all past and profitable memories of your marital and relationship in Jesus' name. Every relationship you have had, anything that would make you to remember, let it be furnished away in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the memory to be furnished. Let the memory to be removed. Anything that has been done, what the enemy has done to you, bringing it into your memory, that does not want to go. Let the blood of Jesus wash it away in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it go, because God is coming to deliver you. He cannot deliver you when you have that bad memory. You know the children of Israel, when they were in Egypt, they had bad memory. The way they were being used, they were worked and beaten, and they were not paid. They were bitter, but they had to let it go, and their life they continue with life. So you have to let the past memory go and forgive people. Forgive your enemies. Forgive them. Let them go. Release them from your life, from your heart. Then the Lord will deliver you. If you cannot forgive them, it cannot work for you. Even if God cannot help you, if you cannot forgive them, release them from your heart. Release them and let them go so that God can help you. If the demons, they will remind you, they bring the memory. Say, I have forgiven the person and I have forgotten. It is very painful, yes, but you have to let it go, and God will help you. Some people, they said, yes, it's very difficult to forgive, but it is possible. There's nothing difficult that God cannot do. It's you to discipline yourself and let it go, and God will deliver you in Jesus' name. These are the things that is holding some people. You think you are forgiven, but you are not forgiven. You are not forgiving. You think you are, some people have very bad heart. You think they forgive, but they don't forgive. They are still holding it. That's why the enemy is looking at them, and they see, yes, he's still holding our property. We will go for it. If you forgive and forget. If you don't forgive, you just say you don't want to forgive. But the Bible is telling us, forgive 77 times 7, which means forgiveness is forever. It doesn't have a number. So you have to forgive and forget and move with your life in Jesus' name. I pray that God to remove your name from the book of broken homes in the mighty name of Jesus. Let God remove your name from the home, from broken homes. Let God remove your name from broken homes in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let the corruption of your marriage receive fire in the name of Jesus. I am talking too much marriage because I know some people all over the world. Some of them, they are going really very difficult time with their marriage. I am praying that let this marriage be restored in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, you are so good. I want to thank God so much. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye to you. Tomorrow we are on midnight. We are on midnight up to Thursday. So if you want to go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca, or you can email me. You can email us, overcomersdhm@gmail.com. I will pray for you. If you need prayers, if you need these prayer points, you want them to pray, call me, I will give it to you. Yes. Thank you, treasure. We pray that God will deliver you. Thank you so much. I have to stop here. God bless you and have a good night or a good morning in your country. I'll see you tomorrow. Yes. Oh, yes. Happy anniversary. Happy anniversary to you. Oh, Catherine, you have an anniversary. God bless you so much. Thank you so much, my sister. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. I love you so much. I love you, and there's nothing I can do about it. Have a nice and wonderful time in Jesus' name. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.